Hello friends, welcome to my channel. So today I am going to work on this employee part. So let's get started and work on this simple employee part of our project Python Django Medical Store Management System. So let's get started. First, image it, then back to PyCharm, and let's create a view set for our employee. So here, if you see, I already created a model. You can see this model here, employee. Now let's create this view set of model. So first, come to views.py. After that, here in previous tutorial, I create a view set for company account view set. So just copy this view set. Copy this view set, copy it and paste it again. Change this to employee view set. After that, change this class name. So let's make it employee view set. After that, let's change this serializer. So let's see what is the serializer name for our employee. So open serializer, and here you can see employee serializer. So copy this, and you can see it's connected to our employee model. So just copy this serializer name. After that, come to views.py, and here change this to employee serializer. After that, import this employee serializer by clicking Alt plus Enter, and select this employee serializer from Django medical app dot serializer. So import this also, import it. After that, we need to do some changes. So here, first it's creating a serializer, then it's calling a valid method, then it's calling save method. After that, let's change this response data. So here, change this to employee data save successfully in true, error during saving employee data. After that, here in list method, change this to employee variable. After that, company account, change this to employee. Let's import this employee model. So click Alt plus Enter and select employee model. After that, change this company account serializer to employee serializer. After that, here variable name should be employee, which I just created here, employee many true serializer all employee list data. After that, here in retrieve method, change this to employee query set, change this to employee, and here company account, change this to employee serializer, also change this to employee. After that, change this single data fetch. Everything is perfect for retrieve method. Now let's see update method. So here, change this to employee. After that, change this to employee here also. So here I just copy my view set of company account and just changing the field name and changing the model name and serializer name. After that, we need to change this serializer name to employee serializer. Change this variable name to employee. After that, is valid, is save, save it. So in this way, our employee view set has been ready. Now let's work on this front end part in React.js. So back to VS Code. After that, here let's copy this component of company account. So copy this company account component and paste it again. After that, rename it to change this to employee component. Enter. Now close this company account component, and here I created a employee component. Change the class name to employee component. Let's copy this class name and come to bottom. Change this export to employee component. Now save it. After that, open your index.js file and let's create a route for employee manage. So copy this and paste it again. Change this to employee manage. After that, change this page name to employee component. Page index change to 5. Now save it. After that, open config.js file and let's add a route for sidebar. So just copy this same route and paste it again. Also here, remove it. Now here, change this to 5. Let's see, it's 5. After that, manage employee, and here change this URL to employee manage. So paste it and save it. Now back to Chrome and let's check, refresh page, and you can see manage employee is showing. So click on manage employee and it is showing company account. Now we need to change this data structure and table structure and also form structure to save our employee data. So let's see. First, back to VS Code. After that, employee component. So here, let's work on top. First, manage employee. After that, add employee. And here, let's see field name. So back to PyCharm, open models. You can see it contain name, joining date, phone number, address, and nothing else, only name, joining date, phone, and address. So back to VS Code, let's add this field. So we don't need company field, so just remove it. Here you can see, remove this field. After that, next field we need only name. So change this to name. Name, transaction type name. Okay, here it contain a drop down. So also remove this, we don't need any drop down. After that, let's copy this same div, copy it and paste it again. So now change this to name, also change this to name, and here enter name. After that, next field is joining date, copy it. So here joining date and joining date, change this to date, joining date. After that, enter date and change this size to 6. So in every input I created a 2 input, means it will take 2 space or 2 grid. Now let's see next input, phone. So here phone, and here phone, also change this to enter phone. After that, let's see, change this to text. Let's see next input, which is address. So copy this field name, change here field name address, and here address. After that, here change this to enter address. Now save it back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see name, joining date, phone and address. Let's make it large, so 6 and 6. Save it again back to Chrome. You can see it's looking perfect. Change this text of button, so add employee, adding employee, please wait. After that, everything is perfect. Now here change this to all employee data, first ID, then name, then joining date. After that, phone, then address, then action or added on, after that action. Let's remove this added on, and here change this to this.state.employee list. Change this to employee data or employee, and here change this to employee ID. After that, employee dot name. So let's see name. After that, employee dot joining date. So change this also. After that, move this TD. Phone. So employee dot phone. Next is address. Employee dot address. After that, added on. So added on already there. Let's cut this. Address added on. Everything is done. Now only adding a one more button. So td button class name equal to button default view. Now save it, and let's copy this employee list and registered in state. So come to top. After that, here you can see there are lots of field. So change this to employee list and company list. Remove it company list, we don't need company list. After that, on component did mount, fetch employee data. So copy this method and paste here. After that, we don't need to set company list, so remove it. And this is okay. After that, we need to fetch employee. So open this API and just copy it. After that, come to bottom. Again, paste the code. So here we need to fetch employee. So fetch employee. After that, we need to change this API URL. So open this API URL. And here let's create one more API. So copy this same line and change this to employee API URL. After that, change this API endpoint, so back to PyCharm. And here after creating view set, I didn't registered in urs.py. So open urs.py and here creating us, and here copy the same line and creating a route for employee. So employee, copy it, paste it, and here change this view set to employee view set. Now save this file also, again back to VS Code, and here copy this employee and paste it. After that save it, back to API handler, change this to employee API URL. Now save it, copy this function name, come to employee component, change this to fetch employee, or let's remove this method because we are going to call another method like update data again when adding some data or reading data in the starting. So here let's delete it and here change this to fetch employee, also remove this and paste it here. After that fetch employee, change this to employee data list, and here in state employee list, so state employee list, and here our variable, so copy it, change this to employee data list dot data dot data. After that everything is perfect, so save it and back to Chrome, and here it's showing company account is not defined. So let's see where is this error in line number 207. So 207, let's see. Okay here change this to employee and save it, again back to Chrome, and you can see our data is showing empty because we didn't save any data on employee table yet. So let's save this data first. So back to VS Code, and here after that on form submit we need to save the data, so change this to save employee data, and here we need to pass the value. So first is name, so name, after that let's see model name, or here joining date, copy this. After that let's see next field, phone, phone, next field is address, so copy it. Let's remove this payment mode. After that everything is perfect, I think. Only create this method, so copy this method name and save this page, come to API handler, and here first let's copy this same transaction, copy this save transaction function, after that paste here, change this method, so change this to save, let's see, save employee data, so change the method save employee data. Now first parameter is name, second is joining date, let's see again joining date, so copy it, paste it. Third is phone, fifth is address, let's remove this payment mode. After that we need to save this data in our employee API URL, and we need to pass the data like name, joining date, joining date, then phone, address, remove this payment mode. Now save this page also and back to employee component. Also save this page and let's check everything is working or not. So here first I register employee list, second I work on form submit, third I work on how you can show the data of employee. Now let's check everything is working or not. So back to Chrome, refresh page and let's try to add a employee. So employee name like test, last, joining date change to 29, phone number like 888, address like Delhi. Now add employee and you can see employee has been added and it is showing here. Also change this button text or button color. So let's make it like button primary. Save it, back to Chrome, and now it looks perfect. Also let's try again, add one more employee, test to last, employee date or joining date change this to 29, phone number like 9999, address like Mumbai. Now click add employee and you can see new data also has been added. Now it's working. So our employee manage is working. Now in next tutorial I work on view details of employee, update the details of employee and how you can manage the employee account. So I hope you like the video. Thanks for watching. Please like our video and subscribe our channel.